Hello everyone, welcome back to the channel. I am Nikhil Kumar. In my last videos, we have explored how to manually check your Python code for quality and vulnerabilities, also availability scanning of the container images. Today, we are kicking off an exciting hands-on series all about GitHub Actions, your ultimate tool for automation. In this video, you won't just learn the theory of GitHub Actions. You will actually build your first automated workflow from the scratch. By the end of this session, you will have a working GitHub Action that triggers when you push code to your repository. This is just a start of an in-depth video series where we build a full CI/CD pipeline together. We will automate tasks such as scanning for container images vulnerability, checking Python code quality, and the Ansible playbook linting, all triggered by code pushes and pull requests. Let's start by briefly understanding GitHub Actions before jumping into practical implementations. GitHub Actions is an integrated CI/CD automation platform within GitHub. With it, we can automate it testing, deployment, and many other tasks directly from our repositories. Think of it as your personal assistant for automation, handling repetitive tasks like code scanning, security checks, or even deployment. You might be wondering why GitHub Action is a tool of choice for CI/CD. Let me give you a few reasons. Ease of use, no external setup needed. GitHub Actions is natively integrated into GitHub, and no extra configurations are required for your repositories. Extensive marketplace. GitHub offers a huge marketplace full of pre-built actions. You can use these for tasks like code linting, security scans, or even deployment and more. Free for public repositories. For public repositories, it's free, and even private repositories are affordable. Imagine pushing your code to the repo, and GitHub Action runs automatic checks, ensuring your code is clean, secure, and ready for deployment. That's the automation at its finest. Now it's time to get our hands dirty and build something. In this segment, we will create a basic GitHub Action workflow to trigger on every code push to the main branch. Let's jump right. So first, let's create a repository for the GitHub Action. So I'm giving a name that is GitHub Actions. Now our repository got created. In the root directory, we need to create a folder that is .github/workflow. So that is .github/workflow. So basically in this particular directory, we need to place our all the workflow files for the GitHub Actions. So inside that folder, let's create a file that is helloworld.yml. This file will define our workflow. So let's give a name to this workflow. So that is hello world workflow. Using the name keyword, we can give a name to the workflow. Now let's define the triggers in the workflow. So to that, we need to give on push event, and we need to specify the branches. So right now I'm just specifying the main branch. This particular trigger will run the workflow whenever we push something to the main branch. Now let's define the heart of the workflow, that is the actual action we need to perform using the GitHub Actions. So to do that, we need to use a jobs keyword. Under that, we need to give the name of to the job, that is say hello. And under that, we need to specify the runner on which particular node this particular workflow will be running. So right now we are going with the Ubuntu latest, which is provided by the GitHub itself. So it's a GitHub hosted runner. So we just need to use the Ubuntu-latest here. And then this particular workflow will be running on the top of that particular node. Now we need to add the steps. So for that we have a keyword that is steps, and we need to give a name to the step, that is print a message, and we need to specify the command, that is. Now the workflow file is ready. Let's commit it and push it to the GitHub. So let me commit these changes. Now let's head over to the action tab in the GitHub repository. So you will see a new workflow triggered for the recent push. So to click on that, we can see this particular workflow got triggered, that is a say hello. And inside this, we can see this is a step which we have added in our workflow, that is print a message. And this is the same step. And we can see this is the same message it got printed, which we have specified in our workflow. Let me create one file in the repository and see how it is working. So let me create one file that is test.py. I'm just creating a Python file.
import OS, commit the changes. As soon as we commit the changes, the new workflow got triggered. As we can see, it shows the create test.py. As soon as like something got pushed to that main branch, it triggered the workflow. And we can see it got completed as well. It also print the same message. And there it is. We have successfully created and tested our first GitHub Action workflow. With just a few lines of code, we have set up our first automated task using GitHub Action. This was a simple example, but it sets the foundation for the building more complex workflows. In the next video, we will integrate tools like Ansible, PyLint, Bandit, and more into our CI/CD pipelines. If you found this video helpful, don't forget to like this video, subscribe, and turn on the notifications so you are updated when the next part of this series drops. Let me know in the comments what task you would love to automate using the GitHub Action. Thanks for watching. See you in the next video.